Hey everyone, thank you for joining us for this Hanukkah countywide candle lighting tonight. We're thrilled to have you with us. I'm Rabbi Gordy Fuller. I'm the president of the Howard County Board of Rabbis, and I'll be functioning as the MC tonight. I happen to be from Detroit, so I couldn't help but choose that little clip from a Stevie Wonder song that those gentlemen put a Hanukkah tune to, Hanukkah words anyway. So to help us get into the a little bit more traditional mood of Hanukkah, I want to introduce you to, if you don't already know, Rabbi Dan Plotkin, the educator at Temple Isaiah, who's going to sing I Am a Latke, the Debbie Friedman song. If you're at home and you know it, you're welcome to sing along.
Hello, happy Hanukkah, everyone. Thank you to Dr. Ball and to everyone in the Howard County government who helped arrange this, and to everyone at the Howard County Jewish Federation as well. One of my favorite songs for Hanukkah is Debbie Friedman's Latke song. I had the privilege of knowing Debbie Friedman during her lifetime, and she was an amazing teacher to me. And this song, sometimes she was very, very serious. Sometimes she was a little more fun and silly. This song is a nice mix of both sides of her personality. And we have some fun with the latke, but also remembering the important message of Hanukkah, which is to spread light to the world. I am sitting stuck and I cannot tell you. I'm sitting in my splendor turning brown. I pay friends with the office and the flower. And the cook is scouting oil in town. I said, give up for you what will come of me. I can't keep speaking as I do. I need someone to take the crown and cook me, or I'll really end up in a royal suit. I am a latke, I am a latke, and I am for Hanukkah to come. I am a latke, I am a latke, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. Every holiday has been so special. I'd like to have that same attention too. I do not want to spend my kingly splendor wondering what I'm supposed to do. Mom said, my world set on for Pesach, that's Passover, drop the bird on challah for Shabbat. Pizzas on Shabbat are delicious, and get built a fish, no holiday without. I am a latke, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. I am Hanukkah, I am Hanukkah, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. It's important that I have an understanding of what it is that I'm supposed to do. You see that there are many who are homeless, with no jobs, no clothes, and very little food. It's so important that we all remember that while we have most of the things we need, we must remember those who have so little. We must help them, we must be the ones to feed. I am Malanka, I am Malanka, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. I am Malanka, I am Malanka, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. I am Malanka, I am Malanka, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come. I am Malanka, I am Malanka, and I am waiting for Hanukkah to come.
Thank you, Rabbi Dan. That was lovely. It's now my pleasure to introduce the president of our Howard County Jewish Federation, Dr. Rachel Simon. She's a dentist who owns a large practice in the area, and she will say some words about the federation, but she will also introduce our host for this evening, the Howard County executive, Dr. Calvin Ball. So, Rachel, it's all yours.
Thank you, Rabbi Gordy. For those of you who don't know, the Jewish Federation is a major conduit for Jewish philanthropy and engagement in Howard County. We are a community-driven organization committed to taking care of the needs of our locally and building a vibrant Jewish future in Howard County and around the world and in Israel. Through our annual campaign, we raise and allocate funds to provide for those in need, including seniors, the homebound, the unemployed, and other individuals and families who need our help. In addition, this year we have raised $20,000 in a special campaign just to help those who are struggling with COVID-19 to purchase food and supplies. Our recent Jewish community study, which was conducted last year before the pandemic, points to the real needs the Federation meets. 3,200 households aren't confident in their ability to retire comfortably. 730 households say they're just getting along. 455 households report they cannot cover $400 monthly expenses, and close to 100 households say they are nearly poor. We also learned that we have so many more Jews in our community than we thought. And we don't know all of you, but we want to make sure that you all feel welcome and can get to know us. As a large percentage of the community have at least one person with special needs or health issues, we serve as primary caregivers for their relatives, or have someone in the home with a chronic illness or physical disability, we are also here for them and for those Jewish residents in need. As you will hear from Betsy Singer in a moment, our Jewish Community Relations Council works to foster a civil society, to work for human rights and social justice, and to represent our community with our elected officials and local and state government. Federation also provides programming for all segments of our diverse population to ensure a Jewish community today and in the future. We are proud of how our professionals and creative small staff has shifted to virtual programs, including this community celebration of Hanukkah Joy tonight. But we can't do it without the financial support we get from you, our community, and we are extremely grateful for all your previous contributions and hope you can make a gift to us as you can make your charitable decisions in the end of this tax year. It is now my pleasure to introduce our host for this community-wide celebration of Hanukkah, our Festival of Lights, our County Executive, Dr. Calvin Ball. The Honorable Dr. Calvin Ball is a Maryland native and a Columbia resident, where he and his wife are proud parents of two daughters who attend Howard County Public Schools. He made history in 2006 when he was elected as the youngest council chairperson in Howard County history. He then made history again by becoming the first African American to be elected as a Howard County executive. Dr. Ball, a committed educator, is dedicated to making our community a better, brighter place for current and future generations, ensuring education in Howard County is easily accessible for all our children. As our county executive, Dr. Ball remains focused on Howard County becoming the best county, not just overall, but for all, by being data-informed, people-driven, and expanding opportunity for all. Since taking office, he and his team have prioritized growing ready and successful students, fostering safe and engaged communities, creating a clean and sustainable environment, supporting thriving and healthy residents, building reliable and accessible infrastructure, promoting a small and prosperous business climate, and leading an innovative and efficient government that works better for all of us. Dr. Ball holds a Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy and Religion from Towson State University, Master of Arts in Legal Ethical Studies from the University of Baltimore, where he was nominated for the Spirit of Excellence Award, and Doctor of Education from Morgan State University. So without further ado, there's Dr. Calvin Ball.
Well, good evening, Dr. Simon and everyone else. I want to thank you so much for joining us this evening. A special thank you to the Jewish Federation and the Board of Rabbis. Our partnership is a great example of collaboration and working together for the entire community. Last year, we were able to celebrate together with nearly 80 of our residents and neighbors. This year has been a challenging year, not just because of the physical issues that are related to the COVID-19 pandemic, but being more physically distant, feeling more socially isolated, the related financial challenges, and frankly, a critical conversation in our community about issues such as race and equity. Tonight, on this fifth night of Hanukkah, we celebrate together. But even more than celebrating, we are an example of the light. We are an example of rededicating ourselves to not only our current but future generations. And as many of us saw, buses and trucks with vaccine shipping off this weekend, we can be reinvigorated with hope, a hope for a brighter tomorrow, a safer tomorrow where we will be reunited. And so on this, happy Hanukkah. On behalf of all of the residents of Howard County, I am so honored to celebrate with you, even though it's in a different kind of way, it's still in a very special way. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ball. And thank you for letting us see that nice COVID beard. I like it. We really appreciate your partnership with this event. It's now my honor to introduce Betsy Singer Marcus, who is the chair of the Jewish Community Relations Council, who, as Rachel pointed out, will say a few words about the important work that she does, as Dr. Ball said in his comments about the partnership. Betsy?
Thank you, Rabbi. And thanks to you, Dr. Ball, for sponsoring the Hanukkah candle lighting ceremony again this year. This event truly represents the type of community building that the Jewish Community Relations Council seeks to enhance and promote in Howard County. We call it the JCRC for short. The JCRC works to build recognition and to build mutual understanding among members of the Jewish community and other religious and civic groups in Howard County. We want to bring our Jewish values, like responsibility for repairing the world, we call it Tikkun Olam, to seek justice, our obligation to take care of each other and to teach our children well as we work with our neighbors and friends in Howard County. The JCRC is an arm of the Jewish Federation of Howard County, and we have representatives in JCRC from every Jewish congregation and synagogue in the county. During our first 2 years, we got our feet wet by meeting with local officials and community leaders, joining coalitions, convening a community-wide security summit in the wake of the Pittsburgh and Poway synagogue tragedies, testifying to the Board of Education, the County Council, meeting with local public school leaders, and serving on school system advisory committees. We also advocated for legislation in Annapolis as a partner in Maryland Jewish Advocacy Day. During last summer, we planned our focus for the next several years. We met with 46 social justice advocates from our Jewish community, and we asked them to tell us what issues were the most serious and important to them. As a result, we formed three separate teams to address the issues that they identified. anti-Semitism, racism in Howard County, and support for more diversity, equity, and inclusion in our public school system. We've started the journey toward renewed action by first making new friends and seeking out allies in order to learn and educate ourselves about these issues in a deeper way. Our hope is to identify new opportunities for action to work together toward greater justice for all in our community. You can visit the Federation's website for updates on our work at jewishhowardcounty.org/JCRC. And finally, may our Hanukkah candles bring light to the darkness, a light of beauty, of joy, and of peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Betsy. We appreciate all the work that you do. As Dr. Ball pointed out, this is an unusual year. Not only are we not able to get together as we did last year at their offices, but our religious schools have not been able to meet together in person either. And so we have the privilege of hearing the Kol Nefesh Choir, one of the smaller congregations in our area, under the direction of Cantor Stephanie Weishaar, to sing a Hanukkah song for you. That was really special to get to hear and see the faces of children celebrating the Hanukkah with song. And it's now my pleasure to put the screen on for Rabbi Kim Blumenthal of Beit Chavirim. She is the chair of the Howard County Board of Rabbis. She's the one who really does the work, puts together the agendas, and gets the rabbis moving at our meetings. Kim, it's all yours.
Thank you so much, Rabbi Gordy, and thank you for coordinating this event tonight, reminding us how important it is to be together even when it is physically impossible. Dr. Ball, thank you again for making this a priority each year and for your constant work and partnership with the various communities within Howard County. If my words echo what some of the words we've heard before this evening, that's simply because in this community we have shared vision and ideals, and at this holiday our minds are in the same place. Hanukkah is the commemoration of the rededication of the temple in Jerusalem, a celebration of a victory both religious and political in nature. The small defeated the mighty. Jewish worship returned to the temple. In a sense, things were restored to their former ways, and yet everything was different. We cannot separate ourselves from our lived experience. Human beings are indelibly affected by tragedy, shaped by sorrow and loss. The Jews who lived in the time of the Maccabees carried the tension of trauma and war. In rededicating the temple, the community started the next chapter of our long enduring history, reclaiming, rebuilding, reimagining, rededicating. in this year of tragedy and loss. We look forward to a time of rededication of our own, for our own contemporary society. Indeed, today saw a magnificent milestone as the first doses of COVID-19 vaccines. This reasserted the power and nature of science, of human ingenuity. We are still surrounded by darkness, and yet, perhaps we are beginning to see a glimmer of light at the end of the long tunnel. And so we rededicate ourselves. On this fifth night of Hanukkah, let us celebrate wisdom, the scientific knowledge that has made it possible to fight the virus. Let us celebrate determination, frontline medical personnel and essential workers. Let us acknowledge the miracle of human beings working together across disciplines to create and distribute a vaccine. May we be worthy of their efforts. May we appreciate the sanctity of life. May we rededicate ourselves to pursuing wisdom. May the lessons of the past and present be a source of guidance in our future. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Rabbi Kim. Those are very inspiring words. We get a chance to sing along with Rabbi Dan again. Rabbi Dan, over to you for Hagefekoka.
After Rabbi Blumenthal's wonderful words, I actually would, with your permission, Rabbi Fuller, like to switch songs and sing Al Hanisim. Al Hanisim means for the miracles, for the times that God saved us, for God's mighty acts, victories, and battles that God waged for us and our ancestors in this time. And this is a song that's sung on Hanukkah, it's sung on Purim, and in many places it's sung on Yom HaTzmaut, Israeli Independence Day. And these are three holidays on which we as people did what was needed to make sure that the Jewish people remained free. But we still give thanks to God. And just as we sit here today looking at this miracle of a vaccine coming to us so quickly, and we know that humans played a significant role, all the different scientists and doctors and volunteers in the studies, we are still thankful to God for giving us those miracles of intellect, courage, and of bravery to move forward.
Al hanisim ve'al ha'purkan ve'al ha'gurot ve'al ha'tzuot ve'al ha'milchamot she'asita la'avoteinu bayamim ha'hem hazman hazeh. Al hanisim ve'al ha'purkan ve'al ha'gurot ve'al ha'tzuot ve'al ha'milchamot she'asita la'avoteinu bayamim ha'hem hazman hazeh. Al hanisim ve'al ha'purkan ve'al ha'gurot ve'al ha'tzuot ve'al ha'milchamot she'asita la'avoteinu bayamim ha'hem bazman hazeh. Al hanisim ve'al ha'purkan ve'al ha'gurot ve'al ha'tzuot ve'al ha'milchamot she'asita la'avoteinu bayamim ha'hem bazman hazeh.
Thank you, Rabbi Dan. That was a very meaningful switch of songs, and we appreciate that. It's now time to actually say the blessing on the candles, which I will do in a moment. I hope you can see them. I actually have two Hanukkiot here. This one here is actually made by Ethiopian Jews in Israel. And you'll see that it has five candles in it. This one here. And this one is a more traditional Hanukkah with only four. The reason is, just as we know in our tradition that debate for meaningful things is important, there are rabbis who debated all the time. And two of the famous ones were Hillel and Shammai. And Rabbi Shammai said that we should light all eight candles the first night and then take one away each night, because that would more clearly parallel the little vial of oil that they found, which was full when they found it and first lit it, and then got a little bit smaller each night, but lasted for those 8 months. Rabbi Hillel said, no, we don't go down in holiness, we go up in holiness. So we start with one and add a candle each night until we get to eight. So in deference to our times when a multiplicity of opinions is really worthwhile, we are lighting both ways. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher titanu b'mitzvotav, v'tzivanu le'hadikneh, sher chanukah. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, she'asah nisim la'avoteinu, hayamim ha'ahem, ba'azman hazeh. Amen. It's traditional to sing a song after lighting as well. Rabbi Dan, back to you for that song.
And this is the traditional song sung after candlelighting, the words Ma Otzor Yeshuati. And we'll sing the Hebrew first, followed by the fairly familiar English lyrics. Ma Otzor Yeshuati Lechana Eleshateach Bikon peite filati, besham toda nezabea, le'etachim abea, mitzar hamnabea, azekor beshim itkor, kanukat hamizbea, azekor beshim itkor, Hanukkah Hamizbea, Rock of Ages, let our song praise your saving power. You amidst the raging foes were our sheltering tower. Furious they assailed us, but your arm availed us. And your word broke the sword when our own strength failed us. And your word broke the sword when our own strength failed us.
Toda rabba to you for all of those songs, and to everybody else on the panel, thank you for your participation this evening. Thank you to those of you at home who spent some of your time celebrating this holiday of lights together with us. Again, to Dr. Ball and Howard County and all their staff who worked very hard to help us put this together. We're going to close with one of my favorites. Again, not only did I grow up in Detroit, but I grew up in the 60s and 70s, and so I'm a big Peter, Paul, and Mary fan. And so here is their song called Light One Candle. Many people don't realize that Peter Yarrow from that group is Jewish. And when he wrote the song, you'll notice that the phrase light one candle happens 8 times in the song, one for each night of the holiday. So we'll close with that video clip. Have a very wonderful, warm, happy, and healthy holiday of lights, a happy Hanukkah, and please stay safe out there.
Yeah.
Thank you all for joining us. Don't let the light go out. Don't give up hope. We hope to see you all again soon. Chag Sameach.